In this Chief Architect X13 What's New video segment, I'm going to show off our new design-oriented features. Let's begin by looking at our new dynamic help function. The help system now has a dynamic function that updates to provide relevant information about the task you are performing. While this can be ideal for a new user to help learn as they use the software, we think it can also be beneficial to existing users, providing helpful information. The dynamic help mode can be toggled on and off using the push pin. Chief Architect has a built-in auto-save function that is set to archive your projects every 5 minutes. This auto-save function now works for untitled projects that you have not yet saved. You can adjust this setting in your preferences under File Management. In the Folders category, you can see where these files are saved. The crosshair display has a thickness setting to make it more prominent on screen by increasing the pixel width in the preferences. The project browser now displays a thumbnail preview for most of the elements. There are previews for CAD details, saved camera views, cross sections, the different floor levels, saved schedules, and your wall framing details. With the addition of the preview, you should be able to easily identify and then navigate to that specific view. The previews can be updated using the refresh button. While navigating in your 3D views, use the right mouse button to swap to the mouse tilt mode to traverse the scene. Text can be saved to the library. Once in the library, these text objects can be opened and modified for preservation and reused in future projects. The Undo tool now reverts changes to display controls like color, layer sets, and reference display for a more refined undo operation. Selecting and editing multiple rooms has been extended to change more attributes. With multiple rooms selected, you can change room type, ceiling heights, or moldings simultaneously. Control for the living area displayed has been moved to the general plan defaults. If the living area label is deleted, it can be turned back on in the plan defaults. You can use the Match Properties tool on walls to select and then apply the attributes from one wall to another wall. A new search bar is available in the Plan Materials dialog to help locate items. And updating library catalogs can be initiated using the Update tool button at the bottom of the library browser. For added accuracy, symbols with stretch planes that you resize, such as this grab bar, will prompt you to update the CAD block to match the new size of the symbol. CAD blocks stored in your plan can easily be revised using the new edit function. This will open the CAD block in a separate window where you can make modifications. When you close the window, you will be prompted to save and update the CAD block. When selecting an object to copy through the Edit toolbar, a secondary option is available to center the copy on other objects. CAD objects, like this line, can be centered in elevation views using a new Center tool. And the Trim and Extend CAD tools now work in elevation views, just like they do in plan views. Electrical items can be group selected by type. By choosing a specific electrical item and using the marquee Select Similar, you can quickly isolate those targeted objects. A GFCI outlet is available in the toolbar for convenient placement. outlets can be converted from a standard outlet to a GFCI outlet and back to a standard outlet. Electrical connections can be drawn from switches to rope lights to complete circuits and report run distances and schedules. Slabs and polyline solids have new defaults where you can define attributes like thickness, elevation, layers, and other values for use in your plans or templates. 3D solid shapes now include elevation information that you can define the reference like absolute or finished floor for the top and bottom. Fill style settings for the fill and line style are available. With 3D shapes, you can now do subtract, intersection, and merge between both polyline solids and 3D solids. These Boolean edits can be performed in either a plan or elevation view. Regardless of which view you initiate the edits, they can continue to be edited in any view. And the fillet, chamfer, and other CAD tools are enabled for 3D shapes. And for layouts, we have added a Delete Objects tool to remove elements like CAD, images, text, and layout boxes. These controls can make it easier to transition between projects when copying layout files or developing new templates. There are several great new features in Chief Architect X13, and you can expect to see it this summer. And remember, all new software purchases include a year of support and software assurance. So, if you're not currently a customer, get started today with Chief Architect.